This material is made available to you by or on behalf of the University of Melbourne under Section 113P of the Copyright Act 1968. It may be subject to copyright. For more information, visit the University Copyright website.
Good afternoon. In the last lecture, we discussed about different amplifier topologies for MOS transistor. So they are common source, common gate, and common drain. And the counterpart in BJT are common emitter. Common source is equivalent of common emitter. Common gate is equivalent of common base. And common drain is equivalent of common collector. Means so the only difference is we replace the symbol. All the resistance connections are same. We use BJT, now we are going to put MOS. So when you put MOS, the difference is the current equation, that is different. And impedance, input impedance is different. So first we are going to take common source stage. So common source means source is common to gate and drain. So which is equivalent of common emitter. Because source terminal is, you can consider as equivalent of emitter for the BJT. So that you can remember, emitter source. Gate is base for BJT. And drain is collector for BJT. So common source is equivalent of a common emitter in BJT. So common source, output is sensed at drain and input is applied to the gate. And then when you draw a small signal, this is a Vin, and then this part is open because MOS got infinite input impedance. So that is the reason this part is open. Then between drain and source, you have got a voltage controlled current source. And then when you take into account channel length modulation, you have to put RO, but here we haven't taken into account the channel length modulation, so you don't have to put RO, and then the RD, the constant voltage source that we grounded. So lambda equal to 0. So when channel length modulation equal to 0, your gain, which is equal to minus GM into RD, because from his here, you easily can write down the gain equal to minus GM into RD, which is same as common emitter amplifier. The gain was minus GM into RL. Now instead of RL, you got RD. But then the difference is for BJT, transconductance equal to IC by VT. But then for MOS, transconductance is different value, square root of 2 mu and COX W by L ID. It involves some design parameters, length, width of the gate, capacitance per unit length, mobility of electrons, because transconductance is square root of 2 into mu and COX W by L into ID, which we have seen this equation. So that then your gain becomes this much. But previously for BJT, it was easy, minus GM into RL, and then your GM equal to IC by VT. So CS stage with lambda equal to 0. So when lambda equal to 0 means you are not taking into account channel length modulation, and we are going to find out output impedance. So when you want to find out output impedance when we don't take into account channel length modulation, so in order to find out output impedance, connect a test voltage source Vx at the output and pump Ix current into the circuit. Then short your input because you are finding out output impedance. Then you have to short your input. Then you can write down the equation. It's very simple. Then when you write down here, this Ix that is coming here, that is going through this RL, and then that is providing GM V1. But then you can see that this Ix is actually flowing through only this RL. Why? Because you got V1. So V1, this part is grounded, this part is grounded. So V1 equal to 0. So when V1 equal to 0, you don't have this current GM into V1. So your Vx voltage source is pumping Ix current that is coming to this node, and then from here this current equal to 0. So the current will go through the RL. So your Vx by Ix equal to only RL. So that is the reason we got R out, which is equal to RL. Then what is the input impedance? For input impedance, you don't need to connect a test voltage source because it's pretty obvious. Here it is open. Open means very high input impedance, infinity. So Rn equal to infinity. Then gain Av equal to minus Gm into RL. Here if you put RL, it is equal to RL. So if we take into account the channel length modulation, we write lambda not equal to 0. Then we take into account the channel length modulation. Then the only difference is we connect this RO. So when you connect this RO, then the expressions, the change is gain, which become minus Gm into RL parallel RO. So you are getting this RO in parallel with RO. Input impedance, same. Output impedance, RL parallel RO, because now your RL is coming in parallel with RO. Because again, when you find out output impedance, what you find is, because your V1, this part is grounded, this part is grounded, so no current. So this is equal to 0, so this current equal to 0, Gm into V1. So that you get RL parallel RO. So that is the reason VX by IX, which is equal to RL parallel RO. However, early effect and channel length modulation affect common emitter and common source stages in a similar manner. When you study the common emitter topology, we have seen the similar effect. When you have RO, your output impedance is RL parallel RO. Then your gain is reduced RL parallel RO. So same effect. So for common source also, though these equations are slightly different for GM, but the effect is kind of same. When you have channel length modulation, when you don't have channel length modulation, the effect on the gain, input impedance, output impedance, these are same. Means input impedance anyway not affected for the MOS. But output impedance, it is affected in the same manner as we have seen for the common emitter stage. So if you recall this complete common emitter stage, so now what we are going to do is, can we write the complete equation for MOS transistor, the amplifier equation? We have written a complete common emitter stage equation, that's a big equation for this full amplifier. So when we have this BJT replaced with a MOS, then can we write the equation? So in order to write the equation, we don't have to again derive the equation. So this is the equation for the transistor, BJT, bipolar junction transistor, and this is a big expression. And the expression we have to take into account your R1, R2, RS, source impedance, RL. And then when you design an amplifier, sometimes you might not be using a BJT. Maybe you are using a MOS, maybe because of the high current. And then when you connect the MOS, then you want to know, can I use this equation? Definitely you can use this equation, but then you have to do some modification. So where we have to do the modification? When you replace a BJT with the MOS, the expression for the current is different, input impedance is different, but then we have to take into account those things. So how about this one? We already did it. So if suppose this circuit is collapsing to this circuit, what is the gain? So you got RS equal to 0. Here you don't have RS. So that this is equal to 0. So this will cancel out and become 1. Then what else you don't have? So RL is not there. So you got only RC. Then again RS equal to 0. So this part will vanish. So then you are getting a simple equation. RL equal to infinity and RS equal to 0. So AV equal to minus RC by 1 by GM plus RE, which we already did from this complete equation. We can get equation for other topologies which are simpler than this one. So same thing we will do for MOS. So first what we will do is we will find out the complete equation for the MOS transistor amplifier, common source stage. And then we can do the same for the MOS transistor topologies, common source. So this is the case for the... So now I am going to take away the RL. So this is the equation here. Then my question is... What is the equation? Why I got this equation? When I replace the MOS here, see, this is the equation for BJT. Voltage gain equal to minus RC divided by 1 by GM plus RE, RB parallel R1 plus R2 by beta plus 1 into R1 parallel R2 divided by R1 parallel R2 plus RB. So this is the equation for BJT. Then somebody replaced this BJT with a MOS. Then immediately the equation became R1 parallel R2. Divided by RG plus R1 parallel R2, that is this part. So because here it is RB, here it is RG. Because this is base, this is gate, so that is a notation difference. So this part is same. But the remaining, this big part collapsed to minus RD, yeah, RD equivalent of RC, that is here. Then it became only 1 by GM plus RS. RS is equivalent of RE, so this part. Then what happened to this part? So this part vanished for MOS. Why? Yeah, because beta is the current gain for MOS, which is equal to infinity, because your input to gate current is zero. So then your current gain is infinity. So if you put beta tends to infinity, then this becomes zero. 1 by infinity zero. So you get, you know, this equation. So for MOS transistors, current gain is infinity because you don't have any gate current. Current flowing between gate and the source, because you got a dielectric here, oxide layer. So it will not permit current to flow through. In real MOS, the current is in the order of picoamps. And then your output current is in the order of milliamps. And then if your input current is in the order of picoamps, means you are getting a very high current gain, close to infinity. So that is the reason 1 by infinity is zero, this part will collapse, and then we can get this equation. Again, here also, degeneration is used to stabilize bias point, and a bypass capacitor can be used to obtain a larger small signal voltage gain at the frequency of interest, which we already discussed for the BJT. So same thing we will be doing. The RS we connect here, that is for the stability. Bias network R1 and R2 do not affect the gain if there is no source impedance, which also we discussed for BJT, same applicable to MOS, all the biasing concepts. So here you can see gain equal to R1 parallel R2 divided by RG plus R1 parallel R2 into minus RD by 1 by GM plus RS. We have done this for BJT. So in the case of BJT, when this RG, source impedance equal to zero, then this part will become zero. So this both will cancel out, and then you get a simple equation. But then when you take into account the source impedance, then you are getting this extra term, this resistor divider, or your voltage is being divided. And same we studied for common emitter topology, same applicable to common source amplifier. Then when you connect a capacitor, in the small signal, capacitor is a short. Because you are dealing with the signal, for signal capacitor is a short, then you don't have the effect of RS. And then you don't have the effect of RS. So your gain become minus GM into RD. Again, we studied for common emitter, the same thing we are applying for a common source. So this is a common source stage. And the gain equal to minus RD by 1 by GM plus RS, because this RS is here. If R is equal to zero, you get minus GM into RD. Then we are going to make this NMOS into a PMOS. So how about if you connect a PMOS? So when you connect a PMOS, you can see here, this is a gate, this is a source. Source is grounded. And then this is the drain that connected to the VDD. Same as PNP transistor, when you connect a PMOS, drain we will be grounding. Like collector, you will be grounding for PNP. And then emitter, you will be connecting a voltage, positive voltage. So same we will do for this common source. Source we will be connecting to VDD, and then output is still from the drain. So we'll be having the same equation, minus RD by 1 by GM plus RS. If you draw the small signal, both are same, small signals, for NMOS and PMOS. Even for the, because the circuit, both the circuit will give you the same small signal model. Then, what we can do is, when you design your MOS or CMOS transistors in a chip, I already said people will not be connecting the resistor. I already shown you a slide where we explain why we do not use the resistor, the typical conventional resistor. Why? Because the conventional resistor got, means that need more space. For a given value, you need to put, if your value is a bigger value, then you have to, you need more space in the chip. So if you put conventional resistors, you have to put a big, you need more size in the chip. Your chip will be very big. So because of that, people will be using, again, the MOS transistor as a resistor, varying resistor. Because MOS, if you are operating in the triode region or the ohmic region, you can control the resistance value. So you can easily vary the resistance value using the same size. And then I also discussed another aspect. You can pump much more current, if you recall my previous slide. So when you connect it, then people connect in different ways. Here you can see people connect a different VB, a constant DC voltage. And then, so this is one connection. And then here what they have done is they have connected gate to the drain. So these type connections. So then we are going to study what is this connection. So if you draw small signal, you will understand what is the meaning of this one. So somebody is drawing like this here instead of resistance, then we can draw it and check it. Because this is simple. Maybe before that we are going to study this one. So when your gate is connected to the drain, this type of shorting, whether it is NMOS or PMOS, that is called a diode connected load. So it is called a diode connected load. Diode connected load means your drain, this is the drain, and this gate, drain and gate short together, and then replace a resistor. You can use it as a small resistor. That is called a diode connected load, this type of connections. So then I can show you the diode connected load. So this is a diode connected load. So this is a diode connected load for a PMOS. A MOSFET can operate as a small signal resistor. I have mentioned a small signal resistor if its gates and drain, so this is a gate and a drain, are shorted. So these type of connections is called a diode connected device or a diode connected load. This is called a diode connected device. When you use this one to replace a resistor, we call it as a diode connected load. So means this can operate as a small signal resistor. How can I say small signal resistor? So what you can do is then we will draw the small signal diagram. So when you draw the small signal, so this is a gate. Between gate and source, so this is a connection here. Maybe I'll keep it open. So gate and source, you got infinite impedance. So then that's open. And then this is your source. And then between source and the drain, you got a current, so current, voltage dependent current source. So this is your VG. And then I am going to connect here positive, here negative. And then if you take into account channel length modulation, you have to, because this is a real MOS. And then what you find is this part, what is happening? Your drain. See, the drain, because this is a constant DC voltage grounded. But then your gate and drain shorted. So this is your gate, see? And then when you connect like this, when you look from here, what is happening? When you look from here, this is actually RO, the effect of RO, because what is VG? Yep. And then you get, that's the reason, this is kind of a small signal resistor. So then this we can use for replacing. When you got a MOS, when you want to design a MOS amplifier, then what you will do is, instead of this resistor, here you need a resistor, but then I can connect a diode connected load here. And then we also saw another one on the slide in the RD. Here RD you have replaced with another MOS transistor here. And then what will happen is, when you replace it, see, this is the one, then here you are connecting a constant DC voltage. So this is also, when you draw the small signal, you can understand constant DC voltage. That is grounded, the input gate. And then you are getting a open here, and then this is your source. Then here you are getting a, so here is ground here. So that's the reason here it is ground, source, and then you are getting RO, and then this is a connection. See, this is a connection. When you look through here, and then this is your VG. So here, again, VG equal to here, zero. Because this is ground. So this is no effect, again RO. So this also, this type of connection also can give you a resistor value. Then that is the reason we can replace your conventional resistor with MOS transistor. So this will give you the idea. So the diode connected load is a MOSFET can operate as a small signal resistor if gates and drain are shorted together. Then when you short here, there is another advantage. What is advantage? This will never go into triode region, because your gate and drain, both voltages are same, so that it will be operating at the edge of triode region. It will never go to the triode region. It will stay in the edge of triode region. So that is the reason here they have connected. Here they have used the PMOS, and then here this is a PMOS V-in, and then here we have used NMOS. And then the question is, why they have used PMOS here, why they haven't used NMOS here, why they haven't used NMOS here, that we will study in the coming slides, how to connect it. When you make it, you have to be careful when you connect these things. So at the moment, you don't have to care about, you know, why we have used PMOS here, why we have used NMOS here, why can't we use PMOS here, why can't we use NMOS here. So that we will study in the coming slides. But then at the moment, what you have to understand is, instead of this conventional resistor, in the original chip design, people will be using a MOS to replace these resistors. And then we can set different voltage values, and then we can get different resistance values, because you can operate MOS in the triode ohmic region, and then you can get a different resistance value with respect to different VB, DC voltages. And then when you short gate with drain, there also you are getting a diode connected load, which is also is a small signal resistor. So then when you find out when you find out what is the impedance here, when you look from here, what is the impedance? Then the impedance what you get is 1 by GM3 parallel RO3. So that is the impedance you will be seeing when you find out, which we already did it in the previous lectures, to find out impedance from here. Then we already got around the same equation, 1 by GM3 parallel RO3. And then for this one, it is straightforward. So when you look down, you will be seeing only RO2. So then, you can modify the equation, voltage gain, which is equal to minus RO2 divided by 1 by GM1 plus 1 by GM3 parallel RO3, because your RD is, which is your RD. So this RD, instead of RD, you got 1 by GM parallel RO3, and then 1 by GM, so that the GM is for this MOS transistor. So that is 1 by GM plus 1 by GM3 parallel RO3. See, that is your RS. So this is your RS, because this is a PMOS, not NMOS. So you have to look at this one. So when you look at this one, your RD, so which is your RD? So this is the equation. RD is equivalent of RO2. So that is the reason we use this one. Minus RO2 divided by, and then 1 by GM. So GM is for this transistor, PMOS. So here same with this one, that is M1. So that is the reason, 1 by GM1. Then you got RS. So RS is this one. So equivalent of RS is 1 by GM3 parallel RO3. So that is the reason you are getting this equation, which we already derived it. So if you have any questions, you can ask me or come and see me, because with these things we already derived previously. It is much easier for the MOS part, because your R pi equal to infinity. So M1 acts as input device, M3 as source resistance, and M2 as load. So that's what we have shown. Output impedance of common source stage with degeneration with channel length modulation. So again, we have found out the output impedance of common emitter stage when we studied BJT. So for MOS transistor, the question is, what is the impedance? Output impedance of common source stage with degeneration, with RS, with channel length modulation. So we already derived the same for the BJT, the equation, because when you look from here, you will be seeing RO, and then you will be seeing RS, but then it will not be RO plus RS. You will be getting a much bigger value because of this degeneration, which we already studied, and we derived the expression. I derived it on a paper for BJT. Now we are going to derive for MOS. So when you draw the small signal, because we are finding output impedance, we will be shorting the input. But here, anyway, it's a DC. Anyway, you will be shorting. So you got a V1. Your input is shorted, because when you find output impedance, you connect a test voltage source, and then IX current is going in, then you short your input. And then between gate and source, you got RS. Then you got GM into V1, then your IO, and then this is IX. So from here, we can write down, immediately we can write down V1. So what is your V1? Because IX current is coming to this node, and then that is dividing into two. So one part is GM into V1, another part will flow through this one. That is equal to some I1 or something. Some current is flowing. And then both the current will combine here, and here what you get is IX. IX will come out. So when the IX will come here, it can't flow through this one because here it is anyway, it is open. So the IX will pass through this RS. So that is the reason your V1, which is equal to minus IX into RS. Minus IX means here I put positive, here I connected negative. Because I connected this positive to the ground, that is the reason we get to minus IX into RS. You can do other way. You can put this negative, this positive, so the arrow will go up. So you can do, you know, that way. I showed you that derivation when we studied BJT. So that is the reason V1 equal to minus IX into RS. So IX is coming and flowing through RS. Current through RO. So what is the current through RO? Yeah, so in order to find the current through RO, which is equal to IX, current is coming, GM V1 is flowing through this way. So IX minus GM into V1, that is the current through RO, which is equal to IX minus GM into what is V1? V1 we already got minus IX into RS. So we put in minus IX into RS. So we get IX plus GM into IX into RS. So then we can rearrange this one. So RO into IX plus GM into IX into RS plus IX into RS equal to VX. So how can I get this one? VX. So this is your VX. So this VX, so I'm going to apply Kirchhoff's law here. So we got here one expression, current through RO. So this is a current through RO. This much current is flowing through RO. That is equal to IX plus GM into IX into RS. That is a current flowing through RO. And then when I apply Kirchhoff's voltage law to this branch here, when I apply this, and then this complete loop, what I will get is VX, which is equal to the voltage here. So what is the voltage here? The voltage here is the voltage drop across RO. So which is equal to RO into the current flowing through RO. The current flowing through RO is this much. So that is the reason RO into IX plus GM into IX into RS plus then your IX is coming again here, that is flowing through RS. So VX plus VX equals the voltage drop here plus voltage drop here. So voltage drop here is RO into current through RO. So RO into current through RO is, we already got this. That is the reason we multiply plus voltage drop across RS, which is equal to IX into RS, which is equal to VX. So we can rearrange. You can take IX out and then we can find out VX by IX, which is equal to RO into 1 plus GM RS plus RS. So again, we can rearrange it, which will become 1 plus GM RO into RS plus RO, because you can multiply RO inside and then you can take RS, you know, common. So then you can rearrange 1 plus GM RO into RS plus RO. Or you can, what you can do is GM RO, which is always greater than 1, so that it will can, you can approximate this GM RO into RS plus RO. Then what is for BJT? What we have got for BJT? For the BJT, if you recall, here V pi, we got a V pi time, which made a little bit more complicated. And also for BJT, when you compare, your R out equal to R O plus GM R O into R E parallel R pi. So then for the BJT also, we got something similar. Then if you are not sleeping, what is the difference? If you are sleeping, no point in asking. Yeah, so because R pi here, you can see for BJT, you can take BJT equation and put R pi equal to infinity, then you get the Mohs equation. So because here R pi, if you put infinity, then when you put infinity here, then the lower value will predominate in a parallel combination, so that you get a Mohs. So letting R pi equal to infinity, you get the Mohs equation, which is correct. So the BJT derivation, we can follow the same and then put R pi equal to infinity, you get the Mohs equation. Similar to bipolar counterpart, degeneration boosts output impedance. So what we studied is here also, similar to BJT, when you have degeneration, RS, when you connect it here at source, you are boosting the output impedance. You are not just adding RO plus RS, but what we are doing is RO plus GM RO into RS. See, that much is boosting. So your output impedance is boosted. same as in the case of common emitter amplifier with degeneration, the output was boosted. Then, example, so Vx by Ix, we already got Ro into 1 plus Gm Rs plus Rs. Then again, somebody replaced Rs with diode connected load. So when you replace with the diode connected load, then when you look from here down with the channel length modulation, that is the impedance. So what is the impedance when I look from here down? Yeah, 1 by GM2 parallel RO2. And then because we are taking into account the channel length modulation, to show that we are taking into account, I have drawn this one outside so that it is clear. Now, what is output impedance? Because this is the one that we derived, but when you implement on a chip, you will be doing something similar. You will not be using RS, maybe you are using a diode connected load. Then what will happen to this equation? Because in the chip, we have to estimate what is output impedance of your design. Then in the chip, then when you connect a diode connected load, this is equivalent of 1 by GM2 parallel RO2, when you are looking down from here. If you connect a test voltage source here, you break it and take it out and connect a test voltage source and pump IX current, you will get this value. For the BJT, we already got the value pretty simple for MOS. And then you got RO here. Then the difference is, see, here we got GM2, RO2, and then your RO2 will become RO. So what is your RO here? RO is RO1. So that is, you got RO1. Then you got 1 plus GM. That GM is for this transistor. That is the reason GM1. Then instead of RS, what you have got is GM 1 by GM2 parallel RO2. So that is the reason GM1 into 1 by GM2 parallel RO2. This is for the RS. Plus, you got one more RS. So your RS is 1 by GM2 parallel RO2. So you got this equation. So when you implement in the chip, we will be using this equation because we are not using any conventional resistor in the chip design. Then we can simplify RO1 into 1 plus GM1 by GM2. How can I simplify this one? If RO2 is a big value, then what will happen is, if your RO2 is a big value, what will happen is GM2 parallel RO2, you will get only 1 by GM2. Then it will become RO1 into 1 plus GM1 by GM2 plus 1 by GM2. Means this is the proper equation. If you assume your RO2 is a big value, then it will collapse to this equation. When 1 by GM is in parallel with RO2, we often just consider 1 by GM. Why? Because RO2 is anyways a big value, output impedance, RO2, so compared to 1 by GM. So that we can, there is no mistake in writing 1 by GM2 parallel RO2 as 1 by GM2, because 1 by GM is much smaller than RO2. So we got the PMOS stage. And then with channel length modulation, your gain equal to minus GM into RD without channel length modulation. If you take into account channel length modulation, parallel RO. That is the only difference, which we already discussed. Then how about this one? Somebody made an amplifier, some connection like this. So what they did is, they have got a PMOS, which is similar to this one, PMOS. So at the moment, instead of RD, what people did is, they have connected one MOS here, they connected a DC voltage, so that this is a voltage dependent. Maybe you can, by varying this voltage, you can tune it. Maybe this is now acting as a load, and then again, another MOS they connected, gate they have grounded, drain they have grounded, and then they have connected V out here. Instead of RD, this is the topology somebody used. Then what is the difference here? How can you write down the equation? Two ways you can solve. You can draw the small signal and then derive the expression, or from this equation, actually you can write down. So when you don't take into account the channel length modulation, my question is, when you look down here, what is the impedance you see? When you look down here, what is the impedance you see? RO. When you look down here, what is the impedance you see? Zero. How can you get zero? Because you are looking into source, which is equivalent of you are looking into emitter. So when you look into emitter of BJT, what is the value? So RO is correct, because when you look from here down, you only see the RO, effect of the RO, because this is anyway DC. And then when you have this one, when you look into emitter of BJT, you will see 1 by GM parallel RO3. And then because here you are looking to source, same equation, 1 by GM3 parallel RO3. And then this both are coming in parallel. So now your equation will become voltage gain equal to minus GM1, because this is M1 is for GM1. Then you got RD parallel RO. So what is your RD parallel RO? So what is your RD? So RD is equivalent of all these things. Your RO is RO1. So your RD is RO2 parallel 1 by GM3 parallel RO3. So that is the reason you got minus GM1 into your RD. 1 by GM3 parallel RO3 parallel RO2, then parallel RO, that is for this PMOS, that is RO1. So that is the reason you got RO1. So 1 by GM3 parallel RO2 parallel RO3, which is equivalent of your RD, parallel RO1. So that is the reason you are getting this equation. And your R out, your output impedance, when you look from here, the impedance that you see is RO parallel 1 by GM3 parallel RO3 parallel RO1. So that is this one, your output impedance. When you look from here, see this two and then this one is in parallel. So M1 acts as the input device and M2 and M3 as load. That's what we do. Means what I've shown is even without deriving, you can write down the equation if you know the simple equation. If you know that when you look down, what you are getting. Or what you can do is, if you don't know these equations, you don't know anything, still you can solve it. Two ways you can solve. The one way is, we can draw the small signal. Why don't you draw the small signal, one small signal, and then see whether you are getting this equation. Second way of solving is, you say that minus GM RD parallel RO, and then you know this equation. And then you are connecting instead of RD, then you find out what is output impedance when you look from down. You take it out and then find out. You just take it out, this part, and find out what is output impedance. And then you put it back after finding out. Then you can get, two ways you can do it. Three ways you can do it. One is using this expression just by looking at it. You can modify the equation, or you can draw the full small signal, or you can use the same voltage, this simple equation, and then just find out output impedance when you look down for this part, and then combine. So common emitter and a common source stage with the diode connected load. So that is an important aspect, diode connected load. No early effect and no channel length modulation, because we don't want to complicate now. So common emitter and a common source stage. So when you design, so this will give you some more insight why people are using a MOS transistors. So this is a common emitter amplifier topology. Your gain equal to minus GM into RC. And then if you replace this RC with a diode connected load, then what you will be doing is you will be connecting your collector with base. You will be shorting and then connecting to a VCC. Then your gain will come minus GM1 into RC. So now when you look up, what you see is 1 by GM. That is the impedance when you look it up here, when you don't have an early effect. So then you are getting minus GM1 in by GM2, and then GM1 equal to IC1 by VT into GM2 equal to again IC2 by VT. And then if both the transistors are almost identical, what will happen is your voltage gain equal to minus 1. So if you are getting this one, do you find any problem? So when you are designing a chip using BJT, and then if you are using a diode connected load, I'm talking about diode connected load, you want to replace this RC, conventional resistor is RC. If you want to replace with a diode connected load, when you are using BJT, then you have a problem, because you can't get gain more than 1. Means then this will not work for BJT. But then if you take MOS, same topology, your gain equal to minus GM into RD. Then if you are replacing your conventional resistor in the MOS chip, with a diode connected load that is using another NMOS, then you have an advantage, because that is equivalent to 1 by GM2. Again, same thing. When you look up, you are getting 1 by GM. When you look to here, when you don't have channel length modulation, you are getting only 1 by GM. But then this one got an advantage. Why? Because your GM is not IC1 by VT. Your GM equal to square root of 2 into mu n COX W by L into ID. Then your gain, which is equal to minus GM1 into minus 1 by GM2, same as this one, BJT. But then the only advantage is now your GMs are different. For BJT, you got IC1 by VT. For the second transistor, you got IC2 by VT. But then here, for the first transistor, it will be 2 mu n COX W1 by L1 ID. And then for the second transistor, again, different value. See, when you substitute, which is equal to minus square root of 2 mu n COX W by L of first transistor into ID, because same drain current is flowing. So root of 2 mu n COX W by L of second transistor into ID. But then the advantage is here, you can see you get to root of W by L of the first transistor divided by W by L of the second transistor. If you make W by L equal, then you will get to minus 1. But if you don't make it equal, then you can get a gain. Like, you can make W by L 10 times than W by L2. In that case, you can get gain equal to minus 10. So using MOS, when you have diode connected load, actually you can get gain. And that gain you can control, the designer can control to a specified value, because it is in your hand how much width you want to design, how much channel length you wanted. So this is one advantage. When you use a diode connected load for the MOS, it is good. But for common emitter amplifier, that is not good. So that is the reason MOS got lots of application. Means in the chip design, MOS is preferred, because the designer has the control over it. The MOSFET gain is independent of process parameters mu and COX and drain current, because mu and COX and drain current, that is not coming into picture, is solely depending upon the dimensions, the width of the channel and the length of the channel and width of the gate. So common source stage with the diode connected load with the channel length modulation. So if you take into account the channel length modulation, the only difference is instead of 1 by GM2, you are getting parallel RO2. So that is the only difference. When you look from here up, what you see is 1 by GM parallel RO. So then you are getting one addition, that is RO2. Then your gain equal to minus GM into RD. Then now your new gain is minus GM1 into now your RD. RD equal to 1 by GM parallel RO2. And then for this one, RD. So which one is RD? Minus GM RD, then if you take into account channel length modulation, you have to take into account RO1 of the M1. So you get minus GM, and then your RD 1 by GM2 into RO2, that is your RD. Then parallel RO1, because you are taking into account channel length modulation. So which we already discussed. So that's all about the common source stage. We don't have to study much in detail, because the summary is the common source stage is pretty much similar to common emitter stage. Even the small signal derivations are much simpler for common source, because the fact that R pi equal to infinity. Then output impedance, if you put R pi equal to infinity, you get MOS equation from your BJT one. And then the voltage gain equation, you can put beta equal to infinity, then you get your MOS equation. So that is kind of identical. So the next design is common gate stage. So common gate stage means for the BJT, we know that we connected signal at the emitter when we designed a common gate. So that was a common base stage. So common base means base was common to emitter and collector. Now the equivalent in MOS is a common gate. Gate is equivalent of source and the drain. So pretty much same way we will be connecting. So input is supplied to the source, and then output sensed at drain. The gain equal to GM into RD, pretty much similar to what you have got for your BJT. For BJT, common base amplifier, gain equal to GM into RL, because RC, GM into RC, here it is GM into RD, means both are same, only the notation here, because it is a drain, we are using RD, D subscript. Because it is collector, you are using RC. So the equation is same. AV equal to GM into RD. Only difference is for BJT, GM is IC by VT. For MOS, GM is different. Square root of 2 into mu and COX into W by L into ID. So input-output impedance of common gate stage, no channel length modulation. So what is the input-output impedance? So when there is no channel length modulation, in order to find out input, you can connect a test voltage source, because you want to find out what is the impedance when you look into here, and then IX current can go in. Output impedance, here you can connect a test voltage source and then short the input. So that's what I done. So we are short here, and then we are short here. So that's what we have got here. So when you write down the equation, it is very simple, because your IX current is coming, and then here it is open, no current can go. Then IX current is coming, and then this IX current is providing GM V1. So that is the reason IX equal to minus GM into V1. It's very simple. And then GM into VX, because your V1 equal to VX. This voltage is V1, but that is equal to VX. Actually minus VX, because here you positive have grounded, so your VX equal to minus V1. So that is the reason now minus GM into V1 will become GM into VX. So your input impedance, VX by IX equal to 1 by GM. So that's how we say we get 1 by GM. We have stopped it here. And then output impedance is RD. So the input and output impedances of common gate stage are similar to those of common base stage. So this is just a derivation. Now you know that when you look into the source, why you are getting 1 by GM. If you got a channel length modulation, you will be connecting an RO, then you will get 1 by GM parallel RO. So I have shown you this derivation. And then maybe I'll stop here and then continue the next lecture. Yeah, because we are taking into account the channel and the modulation.
So, could you help me to draw the small signal for this?
Yeah, but then please come. I'll show you.